Hello everyone, I'm here with a video showing you guys how I put the lace wig that you guys saw in my recent Get Ready With Me video in a ponytail. I thought in that video it was pretty clear how I did it, but apparently some people were still confused, so I decided to try to recreate it. The wig that I'm going to be using is from Eva Wigs. The one that I used in the previous video, it's from a different company, but the wigs that I'm using are very similar. It doesn't matter what wig you use either way. More information about the wig is going to be provided in the information bar below. And some people were asking me to do a review on the wig. A lot of you guys might not know, but I no longer do hair reviews, so unfortunately that would not be happening, so I'm sorry. A lot of you guys also know that I cut my hair into a mohawk not too long ago, and because I haven't been really wearing my real hair out, I haven't been maintaining the sides, so it grew in a little bit. This style, because my hair is like pretty short, I can just get away with brushing my hair all the way back and just leaving it there. When my hair was a little longer, I would basically cornrow my hair all the way back and then sew down the ends. Or you can corner your hair going from sides all the way back. For those that always ask me, how do I wear my wigs? I use elastic band. And if you have no idea how the elastic band works, I'm going to leave a link in the description bar as well. So I'm just going to put that on and just position it where I want it to sit. I already made my parting, and whenever I wash my wigs, that's when I part it while it's still wet, so when it dries it just lays better. And as you guys can see, it's sitting right behind my hairline so that the wig is gonna look a little bit more realistic. Then I'm gonna take a comb and just part my own hair. And if you're using a lace wig, it's good if you have your not bleached, because it makes it look a little bit more realistic. But if it's not bleached, that's fine as well. And then I'm just gonna pull a little bit of my hair out right there. Since this hair is wavy slash curly, I'm gonna spray some water on it. Actually, I have some conditioner in this as well, but you don't really need a conditioner. It's just because that's what I have in there right now. But anyway, all I'm gonna do is just spray it on the part where I want to lay down. And you obviously wouldn't need to lay the hair down to make it a little bit smoother on top if you're using like straight hair or something like that. But I don't want it to be like all like too lumpy on top. That's why I'm doing this step. Then I'm gonna take a little bit of gel. The gel that I like to use is the Fantasia IC styling gel. It does not make your hair flake and it doesn't dry out your hair, so that's one of my favorite gels. And I just take the swoop part above my ear like so. I feel like this is so like self-explanatory, but I don't know, some people were still asking me. And then I just grab it all together and put it in a ponytail with a ponytail holder. And another thing, don't worry if you're not able to achieve some of these hairstyles that you see me do on my channel. Not everybody has the same hair length or the same hair texture or whatever, or you might not even have the same products that I use, but there's always ways around everything. Like for example, if your hair is long enough, you can put your own actual hair in a ponytail just like this and then use like a drawstring ponytail, like those little drawstring extensions that they sell for like $20 at the beauty supply store. You can do this with a sewing, you can do this with a U-part wig, you can do this with a full wig. I have another video that I did a tutorial on how to put a wig up in a ponytail. Like that one is more of a high ponytail, so if you want to put a wig in a high ponytail, all you gotta do, sew down the perimeter, leave some of your own natural hair out on the sides. Since my hair is not that long on the sides, so that's why I had to use a lace wig and do this method. And you can also sew down a lace wig, but I wouldn't recommend sewing down a lace wig that you plan on wearing other ways other than sewing it down. if you get what I mean, because you might mess up the lace. I don't like gluing down lace wigs, but if that's your thing, you can do that as well. And to make it look a little bit more realistic, you can bring a little bit of your hair out on this side as well. And I'm just applying a little gel on it. And some of you guys might be wondering, like, my lace wig is a little fuller than normal lace wigs, because most lace wigs come in like 100% density, 110 or so density, because those look like more realistic hair volume for most human heads. But I had mine customized, so mine is a little bit fuller. I'll leave the amount of density that it is in the description bar, as well as a lot of other information that you guys can check out. Hopefully you guys found this video helpful. And I'm also gonna list the link to the video of how I sewed down a wig and put it up in a hot ponytail. And thank you all so much for watching. I'll talk to you all later. Bye.